A very good morning, children. Welcome to our YouTube channel, Academia Ambala. Today, I am going to start a chapter, Nationalism in India, Class 10, History. Up to Class 8, you have studied about nationalism in India up to the Swadeshi movement. And now, we will continue this chapter after that. My chapter is divided into part 1 and part 2. Part 1 covering up to non-cooperation movement, and then part 2 is civil disobedience movement. So now our chapter starts. Nationalism. Now what is a nationalism? It is a loyalty and devotion to a nation. So in this chapter, we'll pick up the story from 1920s and study the non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement. We will learn that how different social groups participated in the movement. Now the First World War and Khilafat movement, and then we will see non-cooperation movement. The First World War, it had an effect on the Indians in number of ways. That time, because India was under a British rule, so there was increase in defense expenditure, more taxes from people and war loans. 1913 to 1918, prices of everything increased, villagers were forcibly recruited, custom duties were increased. 1918 to 1921, crops failed. There was also influenza epidemic broke out, and 12 to 13 million people died due to famines and epidemic. Now, through the war years, increase doubling between 1913. So people hoped that hardships would end after the war was over, but this did not happen. That time only, at this stage, a new leader appeared. And who was he? He was Mahatma Gandhi. Now Mahatma Gandhi, he returned to India in January 1915. And he had come from South Africa. There he successfully fought for the Satyagraha. He led that movement, that is mass agitation, and so here also he brought this idea of Satyagraha. Now what is this Satyagraha? Satyagraha is an idea by which a fight for true cause or against injustice is fought without any violence. It is a, or you can say, it is a power of truth. It is a soul force. Without being aggressive, one can win. It is passive resistance and non-violent. Gandhiji believed that this dharma of non-violence can unite all the Indians. So this is the reason he organized several satyagraha in India. In 1916, in Champaran, Bihar, he inspired peasants to fight. In 1917, he organized a satyagraha in support peasants in Kheda, in Gujarat. They could now pay revenue as crops had failed. In 1918, he in Ahmedabad organized satyagraha for cotton mill workers fighting for limiting working hours. Now Rowlatt Act. Now this act was passed in 1919, right after the end of First World War. It gave government enormous powers to detain political leaders, political prisoners without trial for 2 years. Gandhiji declared civil disobedience movement against such unjust laws that would start with a Hartal on 6th April. Now, Rowlatt Act. To crush the movement, British government imposed martial law. General Dyer, he took up command. Now, on the day of 13th April 1919, Vaisakhi Fair was organized in Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar. Now, the innocent people, they were not aware of martial law, so they were attending a peaceful meeting. So General Dyer, he ordered to close all exit gates. He opened fire on the crowd. Hundreds of Indians died. Indians started to attack the government buildings. This violence forced to stop the movement. Now Gandhiji wanted a mass, more broad-based movement. He began discussing about a unified or united mass action with Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. Ali brothers, they formed Khilafat Committee to defend Khalifa's temporal powers, because after the First World War, winning nations were going to impose harsh restrictions on defeated nations. Ottoman Emperor, who was also the spiritual head of Islamic world, issued or was having his office abolished. He was called Caliph or Khalifa. Indian Muslims decided to defend Khalifa's power and opposed British. So, in Calcutta session 1920, Gandhiji convinced the leaders to bring all the Hindus and Muslims together. And further, the movement was renamed as Non-Cooperation Khilafat Movement. Now, there are different strengths within the movement. How different groups, they were a part of this movement. Now, Non-Cooperation Movement, which was launched by Mahatma Gandhi, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, that is a combination, Non-Cooperation Khilafat Movement, which was launched in 1921. So, many social groups participated and all interpreted the meaning of Swaraj in their own ways. First, the movement spread in towns. Now, middle class participation in large number. Students, they left their schools, colleges, teachers resigned, lawyers, they gave up their practices, council elections were boycotted in provinces, foreign goods were boycotted, liquor shops were picketed, foreign cloth was burnt, people started wearing only Indian clothes, so production of Indian textile went up. The movement slowed down. Two reasons were there, as khadi was very expensive, so poor people couldn't buy it. No alternative institutions for the students and teachers. And slowly, what happened? Teachers joined back government schools and lawyers, they joined courts. Now, how this movement spread in countryside? So, rebellion in countryside. In Awadh, Baba Ramachandra, a sannyasi, led the movement against landlords who demanded high rents. Peasants were forced to do begar no security of tenure. They wanted abolition of beggar, reduction in revenue, boycott of oppressive landlords. They also organized Nai Dhobi Bans, denying them services of barbers and washermen. By 1920, Aud Kisan Sabha by Jawaharlal Nehru supported the peasants. In 1921, houses of landlords and talukdars were attacked, grains were looted. Congress was unhappy as peasant movement became violent and name of Gandhiji was being taken by local leaders to meet their own aspirations. Swaraj in plantation. In Assam, for plantation workers, Swaraj meant freedom to go home in village. Under Inland Immigration Act of 1859, they could not leave tea gardens without permission. They thought Gandhi Raj was coming and they will get land in their own village. Thousands headed home. Because of railways and steamer strike, they were caught badly, beaten up and brought back by the police. Now, non-cooperation for tribal people. In Gudam Hills of Andhra Pradesh, militant guerrilla movement spread. The British had imposed forest laws so tribals could not collect firewood or graze their cattle. The livelihood of tribals were threatened. Government also forced them to do begar for road building. Alluri Sitaram Raju, he was the one who claimed to have powers to heal people and even survive bullet shots. Rebels thought he was reincarnation of God. Raju wore khadi, asked people to wear it, give up drinking, though he was inspired by Gandhiji because did not believe in non-violence. The rebels kept attacking British officials. Raju was captured and executed in 1924. And over time, he became a folk hero. In February 1922, Gandhiji has called off this movement or withdrawn this non-cooperation movement. The main reason for withdrawing this movement was an incident of Chauri Chaura, which took place in Gorakhpur in UP. It turned violent and burned down a police station, killing 22 policemen. So Gandhiji decided to stop this movement. Thank you.